Multiple sclerosis, also called MS, is a disorder of the immune system that affects the central nervous system, which includes the brain and the spinal cord. The brain and spinal cord are connected to each other and communicate with the rest of the body using nerves. Nerves are made of millions of tiny fibers called axons. Some nerves are covered with insulation called myelin. It's similar to a fiber optic cable with tiny colored wires on the inside, called nerve fibers, and thick insulation on the outside, called myelin. The myelin helps the nerve transmit information quickly and efficiently. When a nerve has to do a job, like help you feel a physical sensation or cause a voluntary muscle movement, the nerve impulse travels along the nerve fibers. When you have MS, your immune system stops recognizing myelin as a part of you and starts attacking it. This acts like stripping the insulation off the cable. The energy leaks out through the breaks in the myelin, which weakens the signal. The brain or spinal cord reacts to the damage by producing inflammation and scarring. That's what the term sclerosis refers to. The nerve impulses can no longer move quickly down the damaged myelin. This interrupts communication between your brain and your body, which causes many symptoms, including weakness, tingling, numbness, pain, or jumpy reflexes. These interrupted nerve signals can also cause symptoms that affect the brain, such as feeling tired, having trouble understanding written or spoken words, anxiety or depression, memory problems, and difficulty talking. Other symptoms include trouble with balance and coordination, tremors, pain, and dizziness. MS can also affect vision and eye movements, causing temporary or permanent vision loss, double vision, abnormal eye movements, or an inability to move your eye. This can happen suddenly. Another symptom of MS can be an intense tingling sensation when you bend your head forward. MS can also cause problems with constipation or difficulty urinating. Most of these symptoms can also be caused by milder conditions or even vitamin deficiencies, and MS can often look like other diseases. This is why it can take years before a doctor makes the right diagnosis. If you're being evaluated for MS, expect to provide a medical history, undergo a neurologic exam, and have some blood tests done. The scarring and inflammation on your brain and spinal cord can be seen on MRI scans. The areas often, but not always, match the symptoms you're having. A spinal tap, also called a lumbar puncture, is another diagnostic tool that your doctor might use to figure out if you have MS. You may also have tests to measure how fast your nervous system conducts signals from the arms, legs, or eyes to the brain. The body can make new myelin, so it is possible for symptoms to improve over time. However, sometimes MS attacks the axons too, and they do not recover. This explains why, for many people, MS symptoms get better, then worse, then better and worse again. This is called a relapsing and remitting disease. Patients can have good days and bad days. Less commonly, MS progresses and gets worse and worse. This is called primary progressive MS. Anyone can get MS at almost any age, but the highest rates are seen in 20 to 50 year olds who live far from the equator and who are white and biologically female. If you have symptoms like the ones described, keep track of your symptoms every day so you have a record of what has happened over time. And be sure to see your primary healthcare provider or a neurologist. It's important to get symptoms like these checked out. MS treatment has improved over the years. There are now effective ways to slow the disease, treat relapses, and manage symptoms. The earlier you get treated, the better. So, if you think you have symptoms of MS, don't wait to get checked out.